I am going to start reworking this painting or painting over it. I went through a stack of blotting paper a couple days ago and found this one that I see an image in. And I love to puzzle piece when I'm doing collage, and there's a line here that fits with this line, so that makes me happy because I know I can integrate it really easily into what's here already. And I would like to, if possible, I would like to keep the little bird in some form, so we'll see if that will be possible. I'm just going to tear away a little bit of the stuff that is superfluous. It's not needed. And also it just gets my hands moving. I'm just doing something. Gets me into it. Here's that line, the red. And pull it up a little bit. Yeah, I guess I could see even somehow using a bit of this arm to connect to her. So let's actually, I think I'll just go ahead and tear out some of or the edge of this stuff. Okay. And I'm just going to put it down so there's less. Less time to dawdle. I'm using matte gel medium as my adhesive. Okay. I think that's good positioning. And why am I doing this? Well, this is my least favorite of three panels that I did a little earlier in the year. It was really fun to create it, to let myself be like a lot more abstract than I usually am. But it just sat in my shop, so I don't have space for things to just sit. I'd rather rework it. And take it from there. I'm just taking some of this excess and brushing it over the surface of the collage piece. And I'm going to put some over the little, this birdie area too. And this will just kind of help isolate it once it dries. So like if I want to, if I accidentally paint over something, it'll make it easier to wipe it back and get to this area. And it just strengthens the collage and also protects it a little bit. The same thing. I can remove stuff more easily. I like this bit of hair over here too, so we'll see if I can, I don't know if I can incorporate that at all. This is going to be a lot about losing stuff, which that is what choices are all about. When you make one choice, it means that you can't make the other. Like something has to give. So, I Okay. On this mixture is kind of like golden Titan buff, which this really is my favorite light neutral. And so I use Pebeo's matte acrylic paint. It's my favorite now. And so I mixed my own Titan buff with their ivory and their titanium white. I could mix a little bit of this with the matte gel. It will beef it up and extend the paint, and it'll also matte it down, so it'll take away some of the sheen. But I don't want to go through that. I'm kind of a lazy painter. All of a sudden, I'm feeling like maybe I want to go with something dark and, that wraps around. All right, I'm gonna go with that feeling. And for that, I am gonna switch to a golden paint. I love their Payne's Gray. I'm not gonna worry about it being matte. It isn't, it's just regular Payne's Gray, so it's got a sheen to it. But I can always go over it, the whole thing, with the matte gel, like a coat of it, and it'll push it back. This, unless I am really in the groove, like this is the true pace of how things come together in here. I do a lot of feeling my way through to a decision, and just looking and listening. And there's a lot about this that I like. There's this area here with the marks. I like that a lot. And so I'm trying to, slow down so that I don't end up painting over everything. So, you know what? Just in case I want to keep that, okay, time to dive in. My favorite brushes for pretty much everything are round brushes. That is not like a very typical approach, but I love the way they feel. I like the marks they can make. I love the tapered ends. And I like that I can scribble with them. I can't cover like a whole swatch of, like a whole swath, very easily, like I could with a large flat brush. And I like that. So, and that's just something that has come about by doing. So, some people really like filberts. I used those for a while when I first started painting, kind of for the same reason. Other people really like flat brushes. Just the more that you work, the more you know what speaks to you. What feels right in your hand. So, of course, there are times when I will choose a flat. So I'm squinting, slowing down a little bit, so I can see like the shapes that are forming. And I'm also trying to get some variety of opacity as well. And I'm just letting that happen right off the brush. I'm not, like planning it. just kind of pressing and pulling back on instinct, just playing. And why? That it is just for interest. It's for visual interest, that's all. Now, right now, this is nothing. You know, it's just me cutting in. I don't know what's happening. I'm not seeing anything in particular that's like, oh, I love that. I really am. I am trying to keep this as hair. I love this area. So we'll see. It might end up getting cut. I kind of like the four leg thing, but I don't know if I'll keep that either. Okay. So, I like this being her arm. So I'm gonna. Gonna incorporate that. Then, I like a bit of this, the teal, aqua, whatever, in there too. So I'll just, you know, kind of paint a little bit scruffier there. And I'm gonna let go, I think, of all of the legs. So I'll wet my brush a little bit to get some of the paint to release that is in the bristles. So I'm, as always, when I'm filming, I'm also looking through the flip screen on my camera because that gives me another eye to see what's going on. And I want to go darker here. I can see that would actually help. And then I'm liking these two legs here. So I'm gonna just make them a little bit more folky, which is what I like. And once I get this all down, I'll go back and remove the paint from the areas that, like, I've gone a little bit over the dress, a little bit over this leg. I'll just wipe it back and we'll see what happens from there. So up here, I think I want this blue section to become more of a hand. So, and I can see, just so you know what I'm following, this blue, dark blue spot, that to me feel, here, I'll just show you. It feels like the fingertip curve, like, yeah, the curve of her hand. I can't explain it. So I'm just using that. That's what I do. Looking in the paint to see what I can see. So I'm following clues and cues by what's happening in front of me. So my little bird is still there, and I'm just shaping out the rest of the hand that he is sitting on. And then I will very simply pull him out again, and There we go with this. And so somehow I'll like put a little thumb in because I'm. Oh no, I won't. Yeah, because her this part of her hand is actually on her, like toward her, so her thumb's in the back. Yay! I don't have to deal with that. So I'll just do like some fingerness in there. All right, so just using the powdery bit, like this kind of bloomy bit that's left in the brush. I love that. I love that I got to utilize the arm and, so much of what else is here. I do want to go ahead and try to bring out some green as well. This is just a matte acrylic green that I mixed from the Pebbio paints. And yeah, no like cleaning the brush, especially so at this point it would be nice to have the colors meld, maybe have some color harmony. And so that's one way to do it is just to mix with what you've got on your brush already. And it just brings the colors together that you're adding. So I'm gonna pull it up behind her a little bit. And that is just for the scene. And I use my under paper here as a way to clean off my brush so that my water stays clean longer. And sometimes this stuff ends up in a painting like this. It just depends, if there's any. Before I end up throwing it out or whatever, I will tear out parts that I like. Sometimes they're just a real mess, like there isn't any beauty in them, any or any interest, and so they just get tossed. But I use them for a very long time before anything like that happens. And another thing that I love is you can see the history of the painting still if you look closely. And that is the kind of stuff that I like to leave it. So I'm wetting the areas where I overpainted and just using the brush. This is a Princeton Catalyst brush, so the bristles on these are like they're heavy duty and they're great for scrubbing. Also, I mean, they're great for like if you don't paint the way I do, which is kind of rough, they will keep their shape very, very well. I mean, they work even with the way that I paint, so they're good brushes. And as you can see, it's lifted that color already. So, just with a little water, that's what the gel medium helps you do. Or matte medium, gloss medium, whatever you're using. To wet that again. Okay, so there's the basic scene, and now it's just kind of working in the details. So the next thing I'm going to do, and this just as I'm talking, this just came to mind. One of my favorite pencils is the, nope, that's not it. Where is it? My favorite by the Caran d'Ache Luminance pencils. It is Rose Anthraquinone number 571. And then I also like the Herculaneum. Is it? Hold on. Herculaneum Red number 068. So I'm gonna go into the face. Let me zoom in for you at this point. I'm gonna go into the face with these two probably to begin with. And then I'll most likely bring in some brown as well. I love the pink and brown combo. And this really is just to lighten up the red. So this one, kind of why I usually have two. It's not really enough contrast. So here we go. Now I'm gonna scribble in with my favorite graphite is the Kimberly or the General Pencil Company. They're Kimberly 9XXB. It's very dark and very soft, and it's a larger barrel pencil, and I really like it. So I am trying to stay since the pandemic and my big break from painting, just slowing my whole life down. I think it's probably kind of logically also been leaning more and more and more to a less more folky look in my faces. So to me, that translates as more abstract, just simpler. Yeah, so that's what I'm shooting for with her face. And my favorite way to get this started is with scribbles. I love scribbling. So do a little ear here as well. And start that. And then I also love the combination of any kind of other medium, like a drawing tool, over a painted area. That, I don't know. I just, when I see that in other artists' work, like it just does something. I just love it. So it is something I try to incorporate as well. So I really like the way that looks. All right, let's see if maybe a red would be a good choice for this. Let's see. For the finger. Let's see. So I'm, remembering that it's from the side, so I'm not concerned about making it realistic. I just want to add something. Think that red is too dark. Like if I'm going to add it, I want it to be able to pop. I think that's good enough. I like that. Yeah. Okay, now little tweaks here. Kneaded eraser, which I don't use it to erase like something for good. I use it more kind of blending and pushing back the marks I've made. So there's a little bit of the nose here that I want to lighten and kind of blend. Kind of helps me achieve the grungier look that I like. Little bit of pink here, kind of blending, pushing back with this lighter color as well. Oh, I think paper is peeling up, so now I have something to solve there, which is fine. I'm gonna do, or try to do like a, that might not work. I think I will. Sorry, this. I start to get excited when things start to, like, when I get to really develop the character and I don't finish sentences, especially when I'm filming. It's also like this if I'm doing this in person. Anyway, red cheek is what I'm after. It's. What I've heard anyway over the years is this talking and creating is it can it does it's a doozy on your brain, you know, because you're using. Sorry, hold on a second. Okay, I don't like that. I liked the dark lip better. So I'll leave that. I love these little cheeks. But anyway, you're using, as they say, different parts, you know, to create. And so I don't know. I do know that this happens every time I am filming, and I'm really getting into it. Oh, I love those cheeks. Okay, the bird. So, gonna try this light blue here. And let's just go ahead move a bit into the background so we can bring other colors in here too. And again, I want to keep in bulky. So once I start making moves like that, I can tell when I'm gonna want to use paint or something, or like something creamier to add. So in the tail feathers here, I'm gonna want to do some strokes of paint. I can just feel it. And then I need to go back and problem solve here and decide what tool I want to use to do that. I think she could do with a little bit of light, a little more light in her, in the forehead. So I'm going to try paint there, with that small brush again. And fingers. So actually, I'm just gonna bring that color all the way down the nose and then come back to it. Like, let it dry, come back to it. Okay, then a little bit of chaos whispering down here. And I think I'm going to use this like to kind of define these fingers a little bit too. I like that. So go ahead and flesh that out some. Haha. All right, and what about this ear? Just a little touch. All right, and while I've got this little brush again, let's see here. No, I think this kind of tealy color will be all right. So, I mean, really, this is just all about making a decision and seeing where it takes you. Sometimes it works, sometimes it clues you into something else that needs to happen. It is a lot like life. This. Okay. This feels right to me. I love the moodiness of her face. There's something like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I just love it. It is pleasing to me. And the little bird, it's coming forward the way I want it to. I'm gonna grab the antelope brown ink. I'll shake it up. And I'm just gonna use a very, very little bit. Just a dash and see. If I like that. Kind of makes it look green. Don't know if I like that. Actually, you know what? What I am feeling here. So let me pull some of that off. Okay, because I just felt this, like I think it would be nice to do a swirl. And so, how do I want that to look here? Think it might be nice to separate it a bit. Just playing. I might end up wiping this back, but I can't see what I can't see, you know, so I have to do something to, I've got to try it out. I wonder, I loved when I was younger, my hair was long. I loved ponytails. So, yes, I like that. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go back into this and push it away. Wipe that out. go in with a little thicker color. This area is wet, so it's not gonna look quite right yet. Again, you can see some of the history there. I think I'm gonna go over the blue a little bit more, but leave some of that brown there. Yeah, I like that. And I also liked the whole like one big side ponytail. Definitely a child of the 80s. Okay, a little bit of touching up through here. Okay, I think that maybe I took out too much right here. So I'm going to push that back just with a little water. Yeah, I like that little tweak better. Okay. I could like put a little ponytail holder here, but sometimes you can give too much information, and I think it's clear, like she has a ponytail. So I'm just gonna leave it like that. That's one of those things in the past I would have felt kind of more beholden to spell that out. But in the past few years, I've learned that it is a really good thing to leave room for the viewer to engage with the painting, and that means that you don't have to spell everything out. Okay, I really liking the way that feels. Okay, cool. So, thinking. I think I'm just gonna go with a Pitt pen, which is an India ink pen. And I'm going to add now some brown. And when you put this over acrylic, you can use it kind of like watercolor, and when it dries, it's permanent. So I guess I could also be using Inktense pencils, but because they're not out, I forget about them. But same thing if you've used those before. The Inktense pencils by Derwent. Okay, I'm gonna let that dry a little bit. And let's see. I'm gonna zoom out and then need to put down a piece of paper because I've got some wet areas here that I don't want my painting to sit in. Okay. Let's see. So here, I've got a lot of room to play. And at the moment, I don't know what I want to do. I don't know what I want to do with it. I mean, there's a lot that I see, or not a lot, but there are things I see. There's another little bird here, which makes me wonder, like, maybe I should do like a bird pattern on her top or something. There's a big flower here. And of course I want to put some lights in the sky. So I'm not sure how I want to continue with this one, but I think I'm at a point where I need like some real quiet so I can really work on this, which means I need to bring this filming to an end. And I will share the finished rework on Instagram. And my Instagram handle is the same as YouTube. It is at Mistel Made. And that's my website. I've tried to like make everything, make it really easy to find me. So, Mistel Made. Okay. All right. Thank you so much for joining me. Even though this is not live, I feel like I'm working with those of you who will watch this video, and it is, there's something cathartic about sharing your work. So thank you for watching. Sincerely, thank you for watching, because it is helpful to me to have an outlet to work like this. So, all right, I'll see you around. Bye.